is about painting beach waves or a cupboard. Tutorial of the process of painting beach waves. I will be explaining you some techniques in the background as you watch me paint on your screen. Let's quickly rewind back to the beginning of this project. This was the initial condition of the cupboard. Things were just lying on it. I started sorting them, removing them out. Once the cupboard was as empty as required, the next step was to clean it thoroughly. Any cleanser would do. You just have to be careful not to leave any corner or crevice. Next, I sanded down uneven areas and cleared the dust with a brush. Cleaning the cupboard once again after sanding is a must. To create the base coat, I have used a filbert brush. It gives the capacity of a round brush but a control of a flat brush. I began with a dry palette, filbert brush and tube paints. I have used white and various shades of blue in this painting. I will be listing the shades in the description box below. Let's begin with the first base coat. Here I'm making swift brush strokes with very little pressure. Notice how quick your hand should move. This is a real-time clip. Don't worry if you are not satisfied with the strokes. This is just the first coat. We are going to layer it with more paint. This will add depth to the painting. Marking a rough line of waves hitting the sand is important. You might choose not to follow it while painting, but the chalk line will act like a guide to your vision. I'm trying to create an ombre effect here, moving from darker shades to the lighter shades. Along with the filbert brush, I also used a tiny flat brush for the sides of doors. As those weren't flat surfaces, the corners would have ruined the filbert brush. to get that beach wave effect is not to make defined brush strokes, but at the same time use bold variations in shades of painting and not just simply blend everything. Here I would like to emphasize upon the fact that when you're using acrylics, you must give at least 2 coats of paint no matter what. Here we need to focus upon shades slightly blending into one another. The foamy waves can be highlighted with a sponge. Creating shadow under the waves will give a 3D effect. Let me tell you, even after the paint dries, it is not gonna stick that well to the laminate. You have to treat it with varnish or resin, and I'll show that to you in another video.